एंड वेलकम टू सोलर एक्सपेरिमेंट्स, सी इट योरसेल्फ, डू इट योरसेल्फ। राइट नाउ आई एम स्टैंडिंग हियर विथ माय अम्ब्रेला एज इट इज रेनिंग आउटसाइड एंड यू कैन सी देयर इज अ डार्क क्लाउड एवरीवेयर। सो व्हाट आई एम गोइंग टू शो यू टुडे इज आई एम ट्राइंग टू क्लियर योर मिसकंसेप्शन। मोस्ट ऑफ द पीपल थिंक दैट ड्यूरिंग द मानसून और द रेनी सीजन सोलर के नॉट जनरेट, isn't it? What do you think? Can solar generate during the monsoon? So most of people think it cannot, but I'm going to demonstrate you how and if at all solar generation is happening or possible or not. So I will tell you many examples. Let me show you the first example. This is a solar lamp and it is being charged by this panel. All right. There is a light here, if you can see closely. This light blinks when this panel starts charging. So right now it is disconnected, and what I'm going to do is I'm just going to put this panel here in the open and see if it is charging or not. What I'll do is I'm going to connect it here. So this panel is connected and you see that it is started blinking. It will be difficult to see you, but if I can zoom in here, you see it is blinking. So you can see here this light starts blinking. So it is very clear that even in this light condition it is charging. So I have shown you that this, even this light in the dark condition, in this cloudy condition, starts charging. But let us do some measurements. You know, here we are standing with the solar panel, and I will show you by the measurement how much generation takes place. So this is a panel, this is a 260 watt panel, and it has open circuit voltage of about 38 volt and the short circuit current of about 8.82 ampere. So I'm going to show you the measurement. I'll put my umbrella for a moment. I have 2 meters with me. This is the solar power meter. First of all, let me show you how much radiation is coming right now. Okay, so we measure this radiation in the plane, and this is a solar power meter. You can see here that right now the radiation is about 167 watt per meter square approximately, right? So even in this cloudy condition, whatever you see, still the radiation is 167 watt per meter square. All right, so now let me see what is happening with this panel. So this is a multimeter, this is a positive terminal, the male knob, the female knob, and I'm going to show the voltage measurement. So I'll put the positive knob here, I'll put the at 200, and let me show you by the measurement what is happening. All right, so what you see here is even this cloudy condition, what you are getting is around 33.5 volt. Okay, that's a good voltage, and we know that in order to get the high voltage, you do not need a lot of radiation. So therefore, you always get, even the low intensity condition, you always get a good voltage or good open circuit voltage that we are measuring right now. But the important thing is it really generating current? So I'll show you how much short circuit current this is generating. So I need to change my knobs. Let's put in me off. This is for the current. I'm going to put it here and put it to 10 ampere. Okay. So this is now measuring the short circuit current. You see here 1.76. I told you that this panel has a short circuit current of about 8.82 ampere, and we are almost getting about 1.7. So around 20% current it is generating, and rightly so, because your solar radiation is about 160 watt per meter square, which is about 15 to 20% of 1000 watt per meter square. It should clarify your doubt that even in rainy season, cloudy season like this, when there are dark clouds around, even in the dark clouds, a good amount of generation can take place. If you are not subscribed to channel, do subscribe and also press on the bell icon so that you get notification.